But this tour is very different, and it's a In Your Hands tour. Is that the name of it?
Yes. Yes, and it's really cool. I mean, it's really just all about the music. And we did, you know, a couple weeks of rehearsals, really just being able to play any song that Sugarland has ever recorded, any cover we've ever done. And the fans during the show basically just hold up a sign and say, I want to hear this song. And we all look at each other and run around and put on the right guitars and try and play it.
I was wondering how the request got up. I saw some stuff that you, Travis, and Scott all kind of posted stuff about this frenzy to learn 80-plus songs, you know?
Oh, yeah. Well, you know, we basically, I mean, we play, you know, we're going to play the songs that everybody wants to hear. You know, we're going to play Stay, we're going to play Settle In. Because everybody requests those anyway.
Yeah.
But then we have this whole portion in the middle of the show where we're taking requests directly out of the audience or from, you know, votes that were held online or people, you know, punching in on Twitter during the show. So it's really interactive and it's really fun. And, you know, Jennifer is just, she's so great at that stuff. She's just so on the fly. You know, we'll look at a sign, we'll read it, we'll interact with a fan and, you know, have a hilarious exchange while we're, like, you know, running around, like, how does this song go? What key is it in?
Uh-huh.
How does it start? And then we'll just, we'll try and get through it as best we can. But it's great. It's really, really a lot of fun.
You sent me a couple of clips from Sugarland, and one of them is One Blue Sky.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. They put that one out on their second record, Enjoy the Ride, and it's a song about a flood. You know, and dealing with the aftermath of that experience. And the song starts out with the lyric, Little Annie Vickers is boarding up windows. Vickers is a family name from her hometown that, so she gave a shout out to them, and she used my name to sort of give a nod to me and everything that we had been through with Katrina. And
sure.
So it's pretty neat.
Little Annie Vickers is boarding up windows, and her old dog is stranded on the silos. Hey there, Annie, don't even think it. So much water and you can't even drink it. Well, maybe by Christmas they'll dig up a load. Take whatever you can, girl, and leave the rest for the crow. Leave the rest for the crow.
And you also sent me Already Gone, which you sing backups on in the studio, right?
Yes. That one is from Love on the Inside, their third record. And that one went on to be a number one hit. So I was really, really honored to have the opportunity to sing on that song.
I was already gone.
First batch of stuff you sent me, wasn't there talk about the producers bringing in the touring band for something? What song?
That was on Everyday America. Yeah, they had been working on the second record, and that was at a time when, you know, Jennifer and Christian would bring sort of a what they call a work tape to the band, where it's just maybe the two of them singing with an acoustic guitar, and we would kind of flesh out some of the, you know, arrangement around it. And then, you know, they take it to the studio, and traditionally, the producer hires their, you know, favorite studio players. And so, but on that particular song on Everyday America, they brought in the band, and we got to play on it. So it was really great. And I think that one made it to the top. So pretty fun.
Fell in love out of college. Good man.
some point, Travis told me that is there a song y'all are doing a la New Orleans? Is it stuck like glue?
Yes. Travis had an idea to kind of do sort of a funky New Orleans, sort of like the Meters, you know, sort of rearrangement of the song, and like we do a drumline thing, and we're all kind of shouting the chorus instead of singing the melody, and it's really fun. We have a lot of fun with that one.
All right, let's talk about Sordid Noise.
Sordid Noise initially started as a a production company between my husband and his best friend from really from middle school back in Mississippi, and they started out making demos for people in Nashville, and they really just caught fire. You know, people all of a sudden, it just seemed like all the music they were making was finding a home somewhere, you know, whether it was on the radio or artists they were working with were all of a sudden getting publishing deals, or, you know, it sort of became bigger than what they were doing. And so they brought on a third partner, Jason, who was, or Josh, who was Jason's brother. And Josh really got a hold of the film and TV angle. And all of a sudden, the music we were making was getting put in TV shows, just kind of everywhere. I mean, I think the past year we got like over 100 placements just in various TV shows, whatever it is. It's Pretty Little Liars or, you know, all those shows on MTV. And they need music in the background, so they call our company and we make music for them.
Mm.
And then the other thing we started doing, which I got really involved in, is representing the Sun Records catalog for film and TV. And Sun is the iconic label, you know, home to Johnny Cash and Jerry Lee and Elvis and
yep.
all of these, you know, this timeless music. So it was my job to go through the entire Sun Records catalog that they own the mastering and publishing on, you know, or at least one half. And so that was about, I don't know, 4,000 or 5,000 songs.
Wow.
That I listened to, you know, and tagged and said, all right, well, this song sounds like this mood. So if a TV show calls and they say, I need something upbeat by a girl doo-wop group,
yeah.
you know, I've got all the Dixie Cubs music ready
wow.
to go. And in fact, we just got Chapel of Love placed in an episode of Glee a couple weeks ago, so, which is another crazy full circle thing, because my dad for years played with the Dixie Cups and I would go see them, you know, at Jazz Fest. So to be sort of representing that music now is pretty incredible.
So you guys have become quite a publicity machine, Sordid Noise. I mean, if an artist comes on with you, you guys are set to place them in a lot of great places.
Well, yes, you know, but we're also very selective about who we work with, because we want to set ourselves up for success. You know, in film and TV, for instance, it's a tough market. You know, they want pop rock. They want certain types of artists. So, you know, we try to seek out the people that we know are really going to shine mm-hmm. in the opportunities that we can provide. We're working with this band right now called The Co., and they're really killer. They're getting tons of placements. They were ABC Family's featured artist of the month last month, and trying to definitely do way more than, hey, come make your record and we'll see you next year type of thing.
And I guess I'll give a shout out now to the fact that it's probably been 3 years or so that you've kind of been helping me do the same thing down here and recording tracks.
Yes.
Which I greatly appreciate. You would not imagine the street cred you get for having some name players involved. And when you tell an up-and-coming songwriter that they have the opportunity to have, you know, the likes of Annie Clements, Travis McNabb, Scott Patton, Brandon Bush on their record, holy mackerel, you kind of got to hold them down, you know? It's an exciting
thing. Well, it's great fun for me, you know, to get to play on all kinds of different things and be a part of lots of different projects. So I thank you for for bringing me on board for that stuff as well.
In addition to being with Sugarland, you guys have your own individual projects, and I just really appreciate y'all helping me help the folks back here to take that next step. Annie, I appreciate your time today. I know they're about to kick you out of the hotel there. We're coming close time-wise.
banging on the door.
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, Annie Clements on the phone, the touring bass player and backup singer with Sugarland. Annie, thanks so much for doing the interview.
Thank you very much.
Well, there you go. It's another week of Nightlife and Music with the Maestro right here on Lake 94.7. Don't forget this Thursday night, Voice St. Tammany, the final competition for this season. Be here, Center of Performing Arts, 201 North Columbia Street in beautiful downtown Covington. See you there, 6:30, the doors open. So until next week, so long from the Maestro.